Hey, this is Ralph. In the previous video, we compared a 30-year mortgage to a 15-year mortgage. Now I want to use an amortization table to see what the impact of paying a 30-year like a 15-year would be. So I've already got a sheet set up a little bit here, and you can see I've got some column labels for month, beginning balance, payment, interest, principal, and ending balance. And I've got a whole bunch of rows there going to 360, which would be the number of months for a 30-year mortgage. So let's get to work here. So the first month's beginning balance is going to be equal to my previous sheet, and I'm going to get the loan amount because the loan amount was the same for either of these houses. And then I can just press enter, and that's going to take that loan amount from that other worksheet. So if we change our house information, this is going to get updated too. Similar for the payment here. Let's go ahead and do equals previous sheet, and I will key in the payment for the 30-year mortgage. So I'll just click on that, press enter. I think though what I'm going to do is edit this so that that cell value is an absolute reference. Now the interest charge is going to be based off of the beginning balance for that month. So interest charge is going to be equal to the beginning balance times the interest rate for that 30-year mortgage. Make that absolute, pressing the F4 key. And if I look up here in my formula bar, I can just go ahead and divide by 12. Now let's see what I've got here. B2 times the interest rate, which is in that other sheet's E3 cell, divided by 12 to get a monthly rate. That's important. And that looks pretty good there. Principal, well, that's going to be equal to my monthly payment right there in that cell minus the amount of interest that's being paid. So my payment, part of that payment's going to go to the interest charge, part of that payment's going to go to the principal of the loan. Ending balance is going to be equal to my beginning balance for that month minus the principal. So you reduce the balance of the loan by the principal amount, not the whole payment. All right, that looks pretty good. Let me take a second to just pick a number here, and I'm going to copy the formatting with my format painter, and I'll select those other cells so they're all in a US currency display. Great. The beginning balance for month two is going to be equal to the ending balance from the prior month. Great. Payment should be the same, so I could just autofill that down once. Yeah, payment should be the same each month. Interest calculation should be the same each month. However, notice it gets smaller because the interest is calculated based on the beginning balance for that month. Principal, therefore, will be increasing each month because the interest is getting smaller, and therefore the portion of the payment going to principal is getting bigger. Ending balance, and of course ending balance is finally getting smaller and smaller because each time you make a payment, part of that principal or part of that payment goes to principal, which reduces the loan. Excellent. We should be able to select all of these cells, and I'm selecting the cells in row two, and I'm just going to double click my fill handle, and that should autofill it all the way down. And if I scroll all the way down to 360, payment 360, our loan zeros out. That's the telltale sign that you did your amortization table properly. If your ending balance on that last payment month is zero, then you're correct. Okay, now that we have that information in and it's all accurate, let's jump back to our data. So 30-year mortgage payment was $1,320.67, say $1,320, and a 15-year mortgage is about $1,890. So what is that? That's about a difference of $570. So if we were to pay $570 extra per month, how would that work? Well, let's find out. Let's head back over to our amortization table. Now I'm going to head up to my payment up here, this first payment cell. And of course, this is displaying that normal payment. And I'm just going to add $570 to this right in there in the formula. And that's going to display $1,890.67. Now for these other formulas, I think what I'll do is I'll simply equal the one above it. And then I can select this, just double click on the fill handle for that second one that I've corrected. and that's going to populate all of those others so that they're up to date. Now, what I'm looking for is the point in time when my ending balance goes to zero or technically negative now. So if I scroll down, at some point my ending balance is going to get so low it crosses into the negatives. And that happens around 203 months in. Now keep in mind, 180 months would be equivalent to a 15-year mortgage. So paying off our 30-year mortgage like a 15-year mortgage is pretty close, but not exactly the same. Instead, it's about another 20 months, 23 months, about another year extra. So basically paying it like a 15, we'll pay it off in 16 years. Well, why isn't it exactly the same? Well, our 30-year mortgage is using that higher interest rate. So it's close, but not an exact equivalent because the 15-year mortgage is using a much lower rate. But if you did have a 30-year mortgage and you wanted to pay it off like a 15, then you would pay roughly what that 15-year mortgage payment calculation would be. Maybe a little bit more to get it exactly 15. And there we go. So still using your 30-year mortgage, if you're able to pay extra each month, then you can pay off that 30-year mortgage much sooner, maybe as much as a 15-year mortgage. And that will have a tremendous impact on your total finance cost and, of course, in the length of the loan. Thanks for hanging out with me.